Hey, it's your boy Max, and let's talk about whether you are the right type of person to start a blog in 2021. So, as some of you may know, I've started a lot of blogs over the years and most of them have failed. But the ones that did succeed and managed to turn profit in the end, they ended up changing my life forever because I will probably not work for another person for the rest of my life. This is gonna be like what I end up doing for probably a long time. And since that started happening, a lot of people have started to ask me like whether they should start a blog. So I've kind of been thinking a lot about this lately, how much of it is like innate characteristics and the character of a person, and how much of it is like skill, grit, consistency and conscientiousness and all these like factors we have control over. So I believe I've come up with 5 signs that you might be a right type of person to enjoy blogging and to ultimately have an advantage and find success easier. So, sign number 1, and probably the most important sign of all, is you are patient and you are able to think long term and execute long term. So this is kind of like the hardest thing for most people to hear today, most like millennial, Gen Z types of people. They don't want to hear this in the age of instant gratification where we want something now, we want it like right away. And we're used to seeing all these people like on Instagram with their Lamborghinis and Dubai and all these like Dodge coin kid millionaires or whatever it's called. Like we just want the result right now. We don't even want to hear someone saying like, look, this is gonna take months or even years of hard work. You're gonna have to basically work yourself to the bone for at least 3 to 6 months and then work some more and wait in the meanwhile to see if your previous work is gonna bring any result. And then, of course, there's always the possibility of failure. All of this might be for nothing, or it may even like start bringing some small, unsubstantial amount of profit and ultimately end up in failure. So nobody wants to hear this. If you are the type of person that's willing and understands the risks of like this sort of entrepreneurial journey, then blogging is perfect for you. This takes a lot of time, takes a lot of effort, but if you're used to this kind of thing and you understand the risks and you are still ready to engage in this process, then you should probably start a blog. It will be very good for you. Plus, if you're already aware that like instant gratification is just like an illusion and all these people in Dubai are just like renting their Lamborghinis and this Dogecoin thing was started as a joke or whatever it's called, you will know that this is probably still your most mature, most viable option for an entrepreneurial online business in 2021 and beyond. Sign number 2 that you may be the right type for a blogger is that you have a high threshold for pain, tolerance and disappointment. And I cannot overstate this enough, you will find this process very challenging. No matter what you do, if you start out as an independent blogger, if you're just learning things by yourself, this is gonna be pretty hard. I mean, I don't wanna discourage people, but this is, making a successful blog was probably the most difficult thing I ever did. And I thought about quitting a lot of times, and I actually have like so many failed projects in like the startup graveyard and in the entrepreneurial graveyard that it's almost like even amazing to me at this point, like how I stuck with it. But I guess if you can tolerate a lot of prolonged periods of seemingly endless work with no results to show for while you're watching everyone else like happily live their lives and they're kind of even like feeling maybe sorry for you and they're trying to suggest like maybe you should start a job and you're like, ah, you're just suffering and working and there's no end in sight. Well, you gotta be able to handle all of that, because as this takes a lot of time, all of that time is filled with pain. I know this isn't something many people want to hear, but this is gonna be painful. It will tax your mind, your emotions, your nerves, your energy. It's gonna suck up like most of your time. So if you're not prepared for doing something extremely difficult that still has a chance for failure, then maybe you shouldn't do this. But if you are the type of person that enjoys a little bit of challenge, doesn't mind when things get hard and maybe even like enjoys pain a little bit, which I believe is the motto of the Marines, if I'm not mistaken. Like, and all of these, like, pain is weakness, leaving the body, stuff like that. Well, if you are that type of person, you will not only find blogging, like, enjoyable, but in the end, in the long run, it will be profitable for you. Sign number three that blogging may be right for you is you enjoy writing, or at least you find writing to be sort of like intriguing, maybe, or at least you've always kind of thought maybe you should try it out. Well, this is kind of obvious, right? If you enjoy writing, or if you enjoyed writing as a kid, well, writing is basically like half of what you do, maybe like 40% of blogging is writing. And if you enjoy the process itself, then first of all, you don't even have this burning need to be profitable and do it like just like work. It's not gonna feel exactly like work, because, well, you're just doing something you enjoy. Maybe it's a hobby, maybe it's a passion. You're gonna win in the end. It's a net win for you over the long run. Plus, today, like, if you start a blog today, you will have to write like a lot, and I mean truly a lot. So it's much better if you actually enjoy the process, and you will find that time kind of flies when you start doing this, and you will get better and better, and you will sharpen up your writing skills even more. So it's gonna be, you're gonna have an easier time doing this. Now, if you're one of these people that believes they hate writing, I've heard this term, like, I hate writing, or I suck at writing, I would urge you to challenge that notion for yourself, because it's possible that it's not entirely your idea that you hate writing. And let me tell you what I mean by sharing a personal story. So I remember before I started blogging first, I used to think like I hate writing, and that's just this like nerdy stuff that I will never need, and I can write code for the rest of my life and I'll be fine. And basically, I hadn't written like one single sentence after high school, probably. But when I considered, like, when I started actually thinking, like, okay, maybe I'm gonna have to start a blog, and when I actually wrote my first article, I remembered that I used to write a lot when I was a kid. You know, in elementary school, I actually enjoyed writing, and I did it a lot, and my teacher there was supportive, and probably like the literature teacher in high school wasn't like really supportive, and maybe I kind of shifted away and I kind of stopped reading and I started doing other things. So maybe the love for writing like started fade away, but it was always there. And when I started writing for my blog, I remember like I like this stuff, I enjoy writing. And maybe some of you guys are exactly like me, maybe you have a similar background like that. Give it a shot, maybe you'll find that you actually enjoy it, and that's gonna be really helpful if you're looking to start a blog. Sign number four that you may be the right type to start a blog is if you enjoy reading or researching in general. So, as I said, like, writing is maybe like 40% of the entire process, and there's another 40% that's mostly research and reading, and 20% is like editing your stuff, which I absolutely despise. I hate that part, but reading is also like huge, and you will do a lot of it. So it obviously helps if you enjoy doing that. Also, I would challenge you to rethink this notion if you believe you don't like it, because you may find that it's actually like really, really intellectually stimulating. It opens up your horizons. You start like getting these new ideas that tickle your brain. It's kind of fun. And also kind of related to this is like not just the process of reading, but just doing research in general. So maybe like you like watching YouTube videos, right? That's a form of research, and that can actually bring value to your audience, which you can like, maybe you can watch several videos and you still have to come up with something to give of your own, like your own perspective or your own ideas. But still, this is gonna be helpful for your audience, especially if you learn how to format it properly, how to present your ideas clearly. Your audience will like it, and you will be rewarded for it with eventual profits from your blog. So if you like reading, that's gonna be very helpful for you. And this means like not only reading the topics, the literature in your niche, but I also recommend people to read like, well, everything, basically, from like Shakespeare, Dostoevsky, all of those things, like to the modern like self-help books. They're all really good, and they all contribute to your skill in the end. So if you enjoy reading already, or you suspect you might enjoy it in the future, I think that's a huge advantage for you and it will be very helpful for your blog. And sign number 5 that you may be the right type of person to start a blog is if you are a bit more on the introverted side rather than on the extroverted side. Now, I was a little hesitant to include this point because it's not like it's a requirement, obviously, and still extroverts, I don't want to discourage them from starting a blog because they can do an excellent job as good as introverts, but I still believe introverts will have a slight advantage here. Why? Well, blogging is mostly made up of thinking, reading, and writing. And those three are all intimate, private processes that you do on your own. You cannot think with someone else. You cannot write with someone else. You cannot read with someone else. So it will require you spending a lot more time on your own, by your own, usually like in a quiet room. And if you are an introvert already, well, you know that you are already good at those things. You're not bored as easily. You can focus more. And I think that's why introverts will have a slight advantage in this area. Teamwork and collaboration is still can be useful, but I've done every single article in my blogs 100% by myself. And I believe like you don't need anyone else to do your online business for your blog. So I think that in the end, introverts do have a slight advantage here. So there we go, all the right signs that you may be the right type of person to start a blog. I believe like if you have at least 2 or 3 of these, you're good to go. If you have all 5 of them, well, I'll see you in the stratosphere. You're probably gonna crush it as a blogger. I know you like this type of stuff. Hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. It really helps a lot and I appreciate it. And I will see you soon with another useful video. Done.